Well, good morning, everyone.
Morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to Bell Springs United Methodist Church for worship, either in person, online, or from our parking lot. We're glad that you are with us for worship this morning. Thank you for taking the time to worship. We are here to worship God and give thanks for God's presence in our lives, to hear a word from the Lord, and to offer our thanks and praise to Him. We may be few in number in the building, but God has come to meet us here in this place, and we offer our thanks and praise. So it's important that in these days, in this time, that we remain vigilant, that we not grow weary in doing well. So we are continuing to be adaptive and to offer as many options as possible to worship safely in whatever way that you're comfortable. So we continue to offer two worship opportunities on Sunday morning at 8 a.m. and 9:45, either in person or on Facebook Live. In person, we're wearing face masks, we are social distancing, and we are disinfecting between each service. And today, we've been hand sanitizing, but we now have a hands-free sanitizer. So that's up in the back, so that's you're welcome to use that as you come and go from here. So we're taking every precaution. Again, our priority continues to be safety above comfort and convenience. So it's more important that we worship safely and take care of one another and take care of our community. So we're going to continue to do these for the time being. Again, we're offering all these options for you to worship in whatever way you're comfortable with. I want to thank everyone for your donation, your shampoo bottle donations. We are collecting those. This is for the annual One Day of Hope event. That event is scheduled for October the 24th. So we will collect shampoo bottles between now and October the 18th, the Sunday before. So you are welcome to bring those. As long as we are continuing to offer worship in person, you can bring those to church on Sunday morning. Or you can stop by during the week. Just give me a call or text, and I'll be happy to make sure that somebody's here whenever you come. So help us out with that, and help us to meet that goal. Well, I'm going to give you an opportunity to say hello to everybody, whether you're online or in person. So I'm going to step over to the camera and pan around and let you all wave and say hello to everyone who's online. So Angie's hiding behind the flower this morning.
Good morning.
Wave and say hi, everybody. All right, good morning. So glad you're with us this morning. So thanks for being either in person or on Facebook. If we happen to have anybody who's outside in your car, would you honk your horn? Let us know that you're listening. Hey, there we go. So thank you. So, you know, friends, we can worship God in whatever circumstance is going on in our life. So I appreciate everyone making the best of these challenging circumstances and remaining faithful. So with that, let's find a posture to come into worship, to center our hearts and minds before God, who comes to meet us here. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice
and be glad in it.
Amen. Our opening prayer today will be a litany for Christian unity. This is from our hymnal, number 556. Listen to this prayer. Let us ask the Lord to strengthen in all Christians faith in Christ, the Savior of the world. Let us ask the Lord to sustain and guide Christians with His gifts along the way to full unity. Let us ask the Lord for the gift of unity and peace for the world. Let us pray. We ask you, O Lord, for the gifts of your Spirit. Enable us to penetrate the depths of the whole truth and grant that we may share with others the goods you have put at our disposal. Teach us to overcome divisions. Send us your Spirit to lead to full unity, your sons and daughters, in full charity. In obedience to your will, through Christ our Lord, we pray. Amen. The words to our hymn will be on the screen, so I invite you to turn to the screen as we sing our first hymn, Great is Thy Faithfulness. In keeping with our tradition on the second Sunday of each month to give thanks to God for birthdays and anniversaries, I'm going to share our list today. So pulling out our calendar, I'm going to share the birthdays that we have for the month of August. So this month, it looks like Parker Daniel and Ryan Suter shared the birthday on August the 1st. So happy birthday to Parker and Ryan. Haley Banks had a birthday last Sunday on the 2nd, so we mentioned happy birthday to her last week, so happy birthday, Haley. Aaron Farrell had a birthday on August the 3rd. Charlie Cox on August the 5th. Grayson Suter has a birthday this week, Tuesday the 11th. Tyler Banks has a birthday August the 20th. Jackson Gilley has a birthday on August the 29th. Weston has a birthday on August the 30th. So happy birthday to you, Weston. And Elna Stelp has a birthday on August the 31st. So We give thanks to God for these folks in our church who are celebrating birthdays. Do not see any anniversaries this month for August, so but we give thanks to God for these folks. Can we sing happy birthday together? Angie, will you help us out? God bless you. We love you and we give God thanks for you. I'm going to offer a prayer, a blessing for these folks who celebrate birthdays. Let us pray. Gracious God, we offer you our thanks and praise. We thank you for the gift of life and the gift of marriage. And for these who celebrate birthdays this month, we thank you for their life. We thank you, oh God, for your gift that you created us in your image. And for the image of God that lives in each of these persons, Lord, we honor. And we ask your blessing upon their life, O God. And we ask you to go before them and to watch over them and keep them, and to number their days with thanks and gratitude. And we thank you for your grace that is at work in their life. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Offer our prayer needs and joys. So I invite you to share your prayer request in just a moment. And if you're on Facebook Live or if you're in our parking lot, you can text your prayer requests to me and I'll be happy to share those in worship. My number is in the caption on Facebook. If you're in your car, my number is 931-450-3422. So I'm going to check my phone in just a moment, and if you have a prayer request, I'll be happy to share in worship. Each Sunday, we name one church from each district across our conference in prayer, so we have lit this candle faithfully each week in prayer for churches. And so today, we pray for these churches by name. We pray for Martin's Chapel of the Caney Fork River District, for Old Hickory of the Cumberland River District, for Prospect of the Harpeth River District, for McEwen First United Methodist of the Red River District, and for Normandy in the Stones River District. So we pray for these churches by name today and churches everywhere in whatever form they are able to worship. We'd also lift up our schools across our community. I understand that the case number of COVID has risen to the point where our schools are going to the hybrid plan for this week. So we want to be in prayer, especially for our school system and all of our teachers and students and faculty and staff in our community. So we lift up our schools. We pray for their safety and well-being, and we pray for a good education this year amidst all of the challenges. Also, we lift up the needs of our world. We lift up those who are suffering because of the explosion in Beirut this week, such a devastating loss of life and casualties. So we lift up those folks in prayer, especially today. Well, do you have prayer requests or joys that you want to share this morning? Yes, Becky?
Pray.
Yeah, very good. Congratulations to Allie Shelton, who graduated Tennessee Tech officially and got to celebrate that publicly yesterday. So congratulations, Allie.
We also have several friends that are going through some pretty big health issues. And one in particular is Dwayne Boyce from Shelbyville, and he's in Vanderbilt. His carotid artery bust. So he's got some leakage and he hasn't had a clot removed. And he's in bad shape.
Thank you, Becky. We pray for these folks. Becky asked prayer for friends who are having serious health issues and concerns. And thank you, Becky. Any others?
Unspoken
request. All right. If you have an unspoken request, would you just lift your hand? We know that God cares and sees for each of those. We lift those to God in prayer. I would continue to lift up our loved ones who are in nursing homes. It's a very difficult time to be separated from family and loved ones. And so we pray for their health and well-being today. Well, I'm checking my phone for any text messages. Give folks just a moment to respond. Okay, let's go to God in prayer. Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, we humble ourselves to offer you our thanks and praise. We thank you for the gift of your Son, Jesus. We thank you for the gift of your grace that's evident in our lives. And during challenging times, help us, O God, to be strengthened by your grace. We pray for your church, for these churches that we've mentioned by name and churches everywhere, in whatever form people are able to worship this day. We ask for unity in the church. Teach us, O God, what it means to be a people of unity, to be called to belong to something bigger than us, to belong to your body on earth as it is in heaven. Help us, O God, in our weakness. Strengthen us for every good work by your grace. May we worship you in spirit and in truth today. For those that we've called by name who are in need of your healing, God, we pray for your healing mercy to be present. We pray for the ongoing crisis before us. Help us to not grow weary in doing well. And help us to not give in to discouragement. But help us to, God, rise above challenges that are before us, being strengthened by your grace. We do pray, Lord, for those who are sick. We pray for healing. For those who have lost loved ones, we pray for your comfort and your care. For those who have had a loss of income, we pray that you meet and provide the things for their daily living. We trust, O God, that you are at work in our lives today and every day. Help us to find your joy in the midst of all of our lives. And we thank you for your presence here in this place and in our lives. Help us to proclaim your love faithfully in all occasions. Teach us the way you taught your disciples, and even teach us how to pray. And I invite you to please join me in our Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Our Psalter lesson will be read from Psalm 133 today. And we are currently reflecting and worshiping on the theme of unity, unity in the church. Unity is a theme throughout all of Scripture. We are called to unity. So I'm going to encourage us for the next several weeks to memorize this psalm. So this psalm, Psalm 133, will be the Psalter lesson each week as we go through this theme of unity. And I'm going to invite you and challenge you to memorize this psalm. And so we're going to recite this psalm together. So I'm going to offer a line. I'm going to ask you to repeat it. And as you repeat it each week, my hope is that the words of this psalm and the wisdom of this psalm would settle into your spirit through memorization, that God would call this to your memory throughout each week. So with that, please repeat each line after me. How very good and pleasant it is.
How very good and pleasant it is.
When kindred live together in unity.
When kindred live together in unity.
It is like the precious oil on the head.
It is like a precious oil on the head.
running down upon the beard.
Running down upon the beard.
On the beard of Aaron.
On the beard of Aaron.
Running down.
Running down.
Over the collar of his robes.
Over the collar of his robes.
It is like the dew of Hermon.
It is like the dew of Hermon.
Which falls on the mountains of Zion.
Which falls on the mountains of Zion.
For there the Lord ordained his blessing.
For there the Lord ordained his blessing.
Life forevermore.
Life forevermore.
This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God indeed. Amen. So our next hymn may be a little less familiar, but it is a great Charles Wesley hymn. So this hymn and then our closing hymn are both hymns written by Charles Wesley. The Wesley brothers, John and Charles, were so instrumental in the Methodist movement that brought renewal to the church. And so many of Charles Wesley's hymns live on. And both John and Charles wrote with such a knowledge of Scripture. You can hear the words of Scripture throughout this hymn. So as we do our best to sing through it, I want to ask you to let the words be a focus of your heart. One thing I appreciate about Charles's hymn writing is that his hymns are very singable, and they're easy to sing along with. They really are. So as we play the melody, you'll get the rhythm of it pretty quickly, I'm sure. So I'm going to ask Angie, will you play through the hymn once, and then we'll sing together. The hymn is Christ From Whom All Blessings Flow, number 550.
Thank you.
Our New Testament lesson will be read from 1 Corinthians chapter 12. Excuse me, 1 Corinthians. I'm reading last week's notes. Excuse me. Our scripture lesson will be read from Ephesians chapter 4. Ephesians chapter 4, verses 1 through 3. I invite you to hear the word of the Lord. I, therefore, the prisoner of the Lord, beg you to lead a life worthy of the calling to which you have been called, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another in love, making every effort to maintain the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God indeed. Amen. Let's go to God again once more in prayer now for the preaching of the word. Let us pray. Almighty, all-knowing and ever-present God, by your goodness and grace, we approach this divine appointment for the proclamation of your living word that so faithfully speaks to our condition. Grant our ears to listen carefully to the voice of your Holy Spirit. Grant our eyes to see your kingdom at hand and fill our hearts with courage to respond in joyful and faithful obedience. We pray in the name and to the glory of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Well, have you ever been driving along and something off to the side of the road catches your attention? And before you know it, what happens? You begin to veer in that direction, right? We have a tendency, don't we, to go in the direction that we are looking. And our focus matters. And I think especially in facing challenges and trials like we're living in these days, it's important to know where our focus is at. If we let our focus veer away from Jesus, we're sure to veer away from Jesus in our spiritual life. My hope and my prayer is that we all remain focused, in these days especially, on Jesus. And if our focus is on Jesus, I do believe that we will have the faith, like the early disciples, to dare to live into what's unseen and unknown and uncertain, believing in what can be until it is. If we'll keep our focus on Jesus, we will have the kind of optimism that comes with a resurrection hope that believes in a good outcome against all opposing odds. If we'll keep our focus on Jesus, we will have the compassion to learn to love the way that God loves. If we will keep our focus on Jesus, we will be led in the way of unity. The way of unity that learns to share a common life with others, belonging to the body of Christ, in which we both all receive and give support. You know, the word community is a compound word that's formed with two words, what's in common and unity. And you cannot have community unless there is unity. So I'm going to spend some time the next few weeks here in Ephesians. The letter to the Ephesians is a primary text when you start to study unity in the church. Unity is a primary aim in this letter. Last week, we were in 1 Corinthians chapter 12, another one of Paul's letters to the Corinthian church. And in that letter, in that chapter, Paul outlines what I want to lift up as the focus of our consideration for unity. Describing the diverse body of Jesus being many members belonging to one body, I see in that scripture that Paul outlines three functions. I mean, three important things regarding unity that should be our highlight. First, that God is the source of our unity. We are, I believe, incapable of achieving unity without the presence of God. And the very nature of God reveals to us that God is unity. One God in three persons. The three persons working together in perfect harmony and in mutual support, agreeing one in the other, having the same mind and the same mission. It's a picture of the church. And as the church, we are the body of Christ in the world. So our source for unity, friends, it starts with God. It starts with our relationship with God, and growing out of our relationship with God, a connection to God and a connection to others. So the source of our unity begins with God. We have to start there. And the purpose of unity is for the common good. Whenever we realize the importance of unity, we realize that we do not live in a vacuum. We do not live our lives in a way that does not impact the lives of one another. My relationship with Christ will impact your relationship with Christ, and your relationship with Christ will impact mine. It is something that we share together. And when we gather in worship, whether in person or online or however we are able to these days, what's most important is that we gather around what holds us together. And what holds us together is the common life that we share together in Christ, realizing that we have a dependence and a responsibility to one another and to the body of Christ. So again, first, the source of our unity is God. The purpose of our unity is for the common good. And the expression of our unity is in diversity. In 1 Corinthians chapter 12, Paul outlines the diverse gifts. The diverse operation of the gifts. Realizing that each person is equipped with different gifts. Each are essential and each are important. Not one person can have every gift, but every gift is needed. So these are the things I want us to focus on as we go through the entire several weeks as we reflect on this theme of unity, that God is the source, the purpose is the common good, and the expression is diversity. So I'm going to be in Ephesians chapter 4 for at least a week or two. And as I reflect on what it means that God is the source of our unity, what we see is that our life in Christ is meant to be lived out in communal experience. That our relationship with God is not just a private thing. It involves the entire community. The word that we use to describe this in the church is covenants. That we hold a covenant that we share together in God. That we, by God's grace, are joined with Christ and therefore with one another, whether we like it or not. And if we want to participate fully in the body of Christ, we have to learn this important practice of unity. Because we are called to belong to Christ and we're called to belong to one another. And it's something that requires great intentionality and purpose. Unity, my friends, does not happen just by a lot of work. And a lot of practice, a lot of trial and error, a lot of offering forgiveness and receiving forgiveness, and living into the full promises of God. Now, in the church, we call this the ministry of reconciliation, where God's salvation is at work to reconcile us with God, to reconcile humanity with God and humanity with one another. In the early days of the church, in the fourth, the